In today's video, I'm going to show you how to increase the sales of your e-commerce website with a simple UI improvement, which will only take you 5 minutes to implement and a few clicks. This improvement applies to WooCommerce stores that sell valuable products like clothing, shoes, or any type of valuable product. With this tutorial, you will be able to change the default selects of the valuable products to go from this to this, greatly improving the visualization of the options and making them more interactive. We will achieve this using the YaySwatches plugin that I choose because it's the friendliest and the easiest to configure. Let's get started. This is how a valuable product looks with the default selects in WooCommerce. So to apply this improvement, the first thing you need to do is to go to the administration, go to plugins, add new, and here on the search bar you have to search for YaySwatches. Now install the plugin and then activate it. Now to configure the plugin, you can scroll down a little bit and go to the settings of the plugin, or you can go to WooCommerce, YaySwatches, it's the same. Click there and you're going to be taken to the settings of the plugin. So the first thing is to configure the option settings, and here you're going to see the attributes you have created for your products. In this case, in my store, I only have color and sizes. So I have selected color here, and I'm going to select how this attribute is going to be displayed on the front end. So click on the select, and in this case, since it's a color, I'm going to select color or custom image swatch. Now I have to select the color of each of the colors I have created as attribute. In this case, black, I'm going to choose the black color, then the brown, say this one, dark blue, gray, and white. If you want to select an image instead of a plain color, you can select the image also clicking the upload image option or button here, because you might have a different texture or a very specific color you have for your product, so you can do that also. Now that I have configured my colors, I'm going to configure the sizes. For the sizes, I'm going to select the button option to display the sizes as pills, as little buttons. If I scroll down a little bit, I'm going to go to the Swatch Customizer section. And the cool thing about this plugin is that you have a preview on the right side. So for the swatch style, you can select a square or circle. I like the square better. For the swatch size, you can select medium, large, small, or a custom size. I'm going to leave it as medium. For the border color, in the normal state, I'm going to select a gray, a light gray, just to have a little border here. And for the active color, I'm going to leave it as black, as is it here. For the variant name tooltip option, you can select if you want to see that tooltip appear on top. You can enable or disable. I'm going to leave it disabled. And for the image position, I think the best option is the fit, but you can select top, bottom, and as you can see here, the image is going to change. I'm going to leave it as fit. And now I'm going to go to the button customizer. Since I choose my sizes to be buttons, this is how they are going to look like. I can select again the size, I'm going to leave it as medium, and you can change the background color. For me, I think it looks really good like this, so I'm going to move to the next section, the sold out customizer. You can select if you want to display the out of stock variants with this line, that is the cross line option here, or you can select the no effect in this free version, but on the pro version you can have more options here, grayout and opacity. I'm going to leave it as cross, or you can just hide the out of stock variants. Now I'm going to save the changes and I'm going to see the difference on the product page. I'm going to refresh this. And as you can see, it looks much better now because it looks more interactive. I can see the colors, all of them, instead of having selects that hide the information. So I can select the size and the color. This is perfect. And now I'm going to show you how to display the image instead of the colors. So I'm going to go to the configurations again, scroll up, I'm going to click the colors, and I'm going to change the type to be automated variant image swatches. I'm going to select that one, and I'm going to leave the thumbnail size. I'm going to save the changes, and I'm going to refresh this. And now my colors are the images. These images are taken from the variable product gallery, so that's why I can see the different colors here. If you still don't know how to create the product attributes, the variable products, or even the whole website, I will leave you a link to the YouTube video where I explain how to create an e-commerce website from scratch. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to the channel. Let's continue. Now I'm going to show you how to display the product attributes here on the product categories or on the shop page. To do that, you will need the pro version of the plugin. I'm going to leave you a link in the description where you can buy the pro version of the plugin. So once you do the purchase, you can go to the plugins, add new, and you can upload the plugin here, select the zip file and install now. Activate the plugin. And since I have the pro version now, I can delete the free version. And you can go again to the settings of the plugin, and you'll see now the shop categories customizer. Here you can select which attributes you are going to display on the shop page. You can select the color, the size, or whatever attribute you want. I'm going to select the color only, and I'm going to hide the out of stock variants. I'm going to leave the size as small and the picture size as thumbnail. I'm going to save the changes, and I'm going to refresh my shop page. Now see the attributes for the products that are variable. I can select the different colors, but I want to get rid of this description here. So I can go to the settings again, and I can uncheck the show variant label option. I'm going to save, and I'm going to refresh. This looks way better. And the best part is that I can buy directly from the shop page since I have the color in this case selected for this pack. So this is a really good improvement, and it was really, really easy to implement. I hope this video was very helpful for you. Don't forget to check the pro version of the plugin to have your product attributes on the shop page under the product categories. And also don't forget to like this video and subscribe to the channel. Remember, if you want to know how to create an e-commerce website from scratch, I will leave you the link in the description also. See you next time.